The bumper.
And they're all
we're leaving here. We go. 1, 2, 3.
Head back.
Thank you.
As a young boy, Deacon David Phillips saw the Philadelphia Police Motorcycle Drill Team perform, and he knew that when he grew up, he wanted to be a policeman on a motorcycle. Years later, he realized his dream and became a member of the Philadelphia Police Department's motorcycle squad. But his happiness was to be short-lived. After arresting a local politician, he was harassed to the point of resigning his position. It was the first time Deacon would see the ugly face of discrimination, but it would not be his last. In 1973, after moving to California, Deacon watched as the California Highway Patrol, Malibu Police, LAPD, and fire marshals descended on the Rock Store, a local motorcycle hangar, and issued citations for crosswalk violations. The nearest crosswalk was 2 miles down the canyon, intent to smoke unlit cigarettes and spitting. He was so outraged at the injustice that he organized a protest ride to the Malibu Police Department. After he met with the various agencies involved, all the tickets were dismissed. That day, Deacon learned that with commitment and hard work, it was within his power to make a difference and change an unfair system. Shortly after his first protest ride, Deacon was invited to work with the Modified Motorcycle Association in California, a grassroots organization that worked to defeat unfavorable legislation. In 1981, Deacon started a Bank of California, a rights organization that was run by a passionate membership. He took out a loan for startup funds. He would travel to runs and swap meets in his mobile custom paint shop and talk to his customers and friends about motorcyclist rights while working. Abate meetings were held in the shop. He wrote articles on legislation, safety issues, and national laws, printing the monthly newsletter on a machine that he cranked by hand. Through his leadership, hard work, and dedication, Abate of California grew to 51 locals and has earned the respect of both riders and legislators in California and continues to be a vital organization.
Congratulations, Deacon David Phillips.
Gasket on my 1949 Panhead, and guess who had it in stock? Many years ago, as you saw the first time I ran into the problem with the politicians, was I found out you do not arrest a Democratic politician in the city of Philadelphia. You just don't do that. We lost a good policeman in those days because when they took away my boots, I didn't want to be a policeman anymore. They took away my motorcycle. How could they do that to me? I've been riding a motorcycle since I was 15 years old. My dad took me in with my Indian, and we traded it in for my first Harley Davidson, and it's sitting outside right now. This has been a year of amazing things for me. The first thing that happened was I turned 65 years old and told the federal government, give me my money. The second thing happened was it's Abate of California's 25th anniversary, which means I started that organization when I was 40 years old. Oh my God. So you young people, it's your turn to get out there and do this, and it can be done. 10. I'm really going to embarrass somebody here. Dave Nichols came to me when I have a little shop down in Burbank. And he was the editor, don't hide your head now, of Outlaw Biker Magazine. And his nickname was the Toe Cutter. Yep. So when you go back that far with people, and you go back that far with problems, you gotta remember that somewhere along the line, somebody caused it to happen to you. My nemesis happens to be a guy, a legislator in California by the name of Richard Floyd. The perfect name, Dick. In the 1970s, when I first went to California, Richard Floyd took one of his people whose child fell down on a motorcycle doing 60 miles an hour through an intersection, got hit by a car, and they blamed it on the fact that he didn't have a helmet on. The death of this child. Actually, it was his mother's fault. He was untrained, and she did not supervise her child. That's not my fault. However, Mr. Floyd decided he was going to do a media blitz about this terrible issue, and he did. He put out the media, he was going to have a meeting with the bikers. You know who bikers are. Let's see if I can figure it out here. Aren't they the dirty, rotten, no good biker trash? Remember that? That's what we were to everybody else. Then we changed to Senator Kidnappers. The word was, here come the bikers. We'll bring in the girls. Then it became, but they're on Harley Davidsons. Bring in the dogs. We were the most terrible thing you could possibly be on the road in 1960 and 1970. And in 1980, something happened, and it was called freedom fighting. It came to the fore. All over the country, abates became powerful. They became lobbyists. They educated themselves. They started getting into computers. They started getting into phone modems. They started having conversations with each other. And now, bikers could elect the President of the United States if we would just get it together. We can do this. That's what freedom fighting is all about. It means getting up in the morning and be willing, like my son told somebody, to eat macaroni and cheese for a month because we didn't have any money because we traveled to Sacramento for a rally. It happens. Dedicate yourself. This is not an award to me. This is an award to everybody that gets up in the morning and is disgusted by the fact that when they came out with the new Superman movie, they took the words away. No longer does Superman say truth, justice, and the American way. He said truth, justice, and that other stuff. Stand up in the morning, put on your pants or your boots or your skirt or your blouse or whatever it is that it takes to do it, and say, I am the last of the free Americans. My motorcycle is an extension of my personality, and you will not take it away from me. Thank you for this.